Hey, hallo.
Hebben we er zin in, jongen?
Ik heb er onwijs veel zin in. Dit is super spannend, man. Echt.
And so it begins.
Well, Full and Ferry is the event that carries my name. It's a concert that I'm hosting. It's really, really exciting. I'm responsible for what's gonna happen that night. Although I'm doing it with guest DJs, I'm inviting, you know, my friends to be with me on stage and you know, all together, we're just gonna make the party work. But right before the moment when I appear on stage, I was in this sort of pyramid with the UFO on the floor, you know, and the intro playing that I produced just 2 weeks before. And then at the right moment, I feel the UFO lifting up. And I know there's no way back. Because once I'm visible up there, it's for the next 8 hours. And yeah, that's big adrenaline rush. For me, Full and Ferry is sort of like my sort of dream party. Queen's Day in Holland is definitely one of those events, of course, every year. I think it's honestly the most crazy day in the Netherlands, where everybody just dresses up in orange, our national color, goes out in the street, parties. There's parties everywhere on the street, DJs playing everywhere, music, fancy fairs, whatever. There's everything's going on. It's just really crazy, and I really like to be part of that. Ik vond het wel leuk. Ik bedoel, het is natuurlijk wel een ander publiek dan waar je normaal een beetje voor draait. Weet je wel? Het is het publiek wat lekker dronken wil worden en gewoon wil hossen. Dus alles wat je probeert is even moeilijk. Maar op zich, mensen zijn lekker de hele dag los, buiten. Amsterdam, Koninginnedag. Ja, dat is altijd toch een recept voor leuke feestjes.
This is Ferry Corsten, and I'm really looking forward to seeing you on Friday, May the 2nd in Lebanon with Mix.
Hoe vind je het om hier op te treden?
Wat gaat er gebeuren vandaag?
Nou ja, het is natuurlijk een plek waar best wel hoop gebeurt. En het is allemaal niet zo prettig soms. Maar ja, dat is voor die mensen des te meer een super uitlaatklep om zich helemaal te laten gaan, weet je. Echt, mensen kijken hier echt weken, maanden naar uit. Zodra het aangekondigd wordt, dan gaat het helemaal los. Dus ik heb er heel veel zin in. Het wordt helemaal tof vanavond.
You just heard Dreas, which is an alias of Swedish producer Andreas Lindell.
Since a year and a half, I also have my own radio show right now. And I'm really excited about it. I'm really putting a lot of effort into it right now. It's a weekly show. It's called Corsten's Countdown. And it's basically a chart show. And the listeners are really sort of like part of the show. They can vote after each show. They can vote for their favorite track. And, you know, at the end of the month, I play a rundown of the top 10 most voted tracks. So it's sort of like a real interactive show. The cool thing about this radio show is that, you know, I'm always on the road, but I bring my little setup. My little sort of like radio studio, mobile radio studio, and I'm somewhere in some random place in my hotel room, for example, and I'm sitting there recording my show and then send it back to Holland, and they put it online. Yeah, Beirut is just a really an amazing place. Every time when I go to Beirut, people around me ask me, like, are you crazy you go there? But it's just a special place to play, because these people, they have a lot of, you know, their lives are not as easy as our lives over here. And for them, when something like that is happening in that country, you know, they really make the most out of it, and they go there, they forget what's going on, and they just go there to have an amazing time. One of the initiatives that I was part of last year was set up by the Liberation Committee. For years they've been doing that, that they basically ask a couple of music acts. And I was basically this year the first DJ ever to get on board an army helicopter, and you fly to four different cities.
Nou, we kwamen dus net aan, we zijn hier twee keer omheen gevlogen. En dan zie je, ja, wat zal het zijn? Ik hoorde net een soort aantal van 100.000 man hier staan. En dat is wel gaaf om dat te zien vanuit de lucht.
Ik doe dit als hobby, als muziekmaker, doe ik al even kijken. Nou, dit doe ik al een jaar of 3-24, denk ik.
Weet je, ik ben ook afgelopen weekend in Libanon geweest, om een voorbeeld te geven. En ja, daar gebeuren natuurlijk ook allemaal nare dingen. Maar ja, aan de andere kant, er stonden ook weer 6.500 man helemaal los te gaan. Omdat ze dat juist niet vaak krijgen. En dat is dan ook wel weer de andere kant van de medaille eigenlijk.
I'm sitting there with 16 people, you know, media, friends, and people who work with me, and we're all in the helicopter. You know, and after a whole day of being in your role of ambassador for peace, I just want to see what that helicopter can do, you know? So I was basically challenging the guys, like, hey, come on, show me what you're made of. All of a sudden they pulled this thing up, and we almost went into, like, I don't know if helicopters can do it, but it felt like a looping. We went up like that and just fell down again, and it was like the most amazing roller coaster ride of my life. It was awesome. Yeah.